thank you very much. So you can notice that I'm not Kate Smith, which was featuring in a program. So I was asked to moderate this panel about energy, which is a fascinating subject when it comes to Ukraine, because a very quick glance on Ukrainian politics can tell you that major political crisis somehow deliberately or by accident coincide with major energy crisis. You know, whatever deal is signed with Russia on the pipelines, whatever, you know, we remember the first revolution, we remember the imprisonment of Yulia Tymoshenko for the deal that she signed, and we remember, you know, deal signed by Yanukovych and the consequent revolution. So I don't want to go into conspiracies, but there is something for sure that is two things, energy and politics, go together in Ukraine. Now, ironically, everybody you can talk in Ukraine will tell you, we know exactly what we should do. We should diversify our sources of energy. We should have some kind of solution in case that there is an interruption, like the storage facility. We know that we have to have a better energy conservation, distribution, winterization, and all these kind of things. And we need a better infrastructure. So these are not the new things. I mean, we kind of know about it, and we knew about it already for 20-something years. Now, question is, what is Ukrainian government, or Ukrainian companies, or Ukrainian energy moguls doing about it? And we are going to discuss all these questions in a very knowledgeable panel that is today with us. And you will forgive me if I will give a privilege to our female, the only female representative of the panel, to have a first word.
Thank you very much.